Hi, Pepper fans. So today we're going to be doing grilled salmon with a red coconut curry sauce. So what we'll do is get straight to it. Hi, Pepper fans. Welcome back to the channel. Again, those who are new to the channel, if you find you're getting value out of this content, then contemplate showing your support by slapping that subscribe button. It's absolutely free. Ding that bell for notifications so you don't miss any upcoming episodes. Give us a big thumbs up. And comment down below. I will reply to the comment, and if I like what you comment, I'll pin it to the video. Now don't forget, everything you use in the video today, there are links in the description for the best place to get your Weber products, and the recipe will be down there as well. So in today's episode, we're going to be doing salmon with a coconut red curry sauce. It's an easy recipe, and we're going to be grilling the salmon. Now you can do this with a whole salmon, and it's something you can do on the baby queue, the family queue, the Genesis, even the kettle. It's so easy. All you need is a high heat and your salmon and your ingredients. So what we'll do is jump straight into it. Also, preparation time on this is around 20 minutes. Now you're gonna need some skewers. So if you're getting bamboo skewers, make sure you soak them for at least 30 minutes before you use them. I'm gonna be using metal skewers. I will put links in the description below of everything I use today for the best place to get them from. So what we'll do is start making this sauce. So we'll just grab the ingredients. So now we've got all our ingredients, it's time to start making that sauce. What we're going to do first is chop up our garnish, which is 2 tablespoons of spring onion, ready to garnish after. So we just chop those up and get them in a bowl. Right, so to make our sauce, you're gonna need a small frying pan or a small saucepan. So what we're gonna do is get our Q-ware pan. I'm gonna do it on the stove again because it's windy outside. And I'm just gonna add the coconut milk. So you're gonna need 4 tablespoons of coconut cream just off the top of your coconut milk. And we're gonna heat that up first and bring that to the boil. So while that sauce is simmering, we're gonna sim it for around 5 to 10 minutes. So what we're gonna do now is get the remainder of our curry paste, 2 tablespoons of oil. So you can use sunflower or olive oil, it's entirely up to you. And we're gonna mix that into a paste ready to baste those salmon fillets before we put them on the grill. And we'll just set that aside while we prepare our salmon. So with our salmon, you do want skinless. I just got skinned and I'm just gonna cut the skin off anyway. So So now we filleted the salmon and got that skin off, we're gonna put our skewers through. And now they're ready to be basted and then put on the grill. Once our sauce has been simmering for about 10 to 15 minutes, we've been stirring it consistently. So we're just gonna transfer this now to a jug. Right, so our sauce is prepared, it's set aside, ready for once our salmon is cooked. So what we're gonna do now is light the cube. While that's preheating then, we can get on and start preparing this salmon. So what we'll do, let's get straight to it. So now we're just gonna baste our salmon with our oil and curry paste, ready to go on the grill. And that's ready to go on the queue. Well, so those have been resting about 5 minutes, so we'll just get these plated up and give them a taste test. Once we're all plated up, so it's time to give these a taste test. Absolutely beautiful. That sauce has got a little bit of a kick from that Thai curry paste, but it's absolutely beautiful. Right, so I hope you enjoyed the video and I hope you found it really informative. Now, don't forget, everything I've used in the video today, there are links in the description and the recipe will be down there as well. So as you've seen, I did serve that with rice, but my ideal thing, I think, to go with that would be the sweet potato that I made. And I'll put an iCard above linking to that video. If you haven't seen that one, check it out. I used 4 salmon fillets and I did have the skin on. Can't buy them without the skin. I bought them with the skin on. It was a little bit cheaper. That was the only reason. Again, I only used 4 salmon fillets purely because there was me and my partner and my sons and our fan of salmon, but that's with that sauce, there's probably enough for around 12 fillets. So there's plenty of sauce there if you're catering for more people. So I'd say at least 12 fillets and you would be fine with that amount of sauce. But that sauce tastes absolutely beautiful. It's a really nice recipe and it's really, really simple to do. Like I said, you can do it on the Genesis, you can do it on the Baby Q, the Family Q, you can even do it on the Kettle. It's such a simple dish to do. So those of you new to the channel, if you find you're getting value out of this content, then contemplate showing support by slapping that subscribe button, it's absolutely free. Ding that bell for notifications so you don't miss any upcoming episodes. Give us a big thumbs up and comment down below. I will reply to the comment and if I like what you comment, I'll pin it to the video. So what we'll do is cut to any bloopers and I'll catch you in the next one. Right, so as I said at the beginning, So what we're gonna do first up is chop up our garnish, which is literally 2 tablespoons of spring onion, fresh. So sauce is prepared. So again, those who are new to the channel, if you find you're getting value out of this content, then contemplate showing your support by slapping that subscribe button, it's absolutely free. Ding that bell for notifications, don't miss out on any... Ding that bell...